Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to clarify two of the most misused words in OpenTelemetry. I hear these two terms misused all of the time, and I've done it myself with my trace pusher tool. It doesn't push traces, it pushes spans. So, spans versus traces, what's the difference? The short answer is that traces are a logical collection of spans, but let's dig into that with an example to make it clearer. A span is the smallest individual unit of work that you decide to track. Now imagine you want to represent your day as an OpenTelemetry trace. You could choose to just push a single span that represents the entire day. Let's say it's a 12-hour single span. But because you want to see what happened and when, you're probably going to want to push more details inside that trace. During your day, you do many different things. You get ready, you have breakfast, you drive to work, you go to the gym, and so on and so forth. At this point, though, you have a disconnected set of events. You have getting up and having breakfast and going to the gym. And of course, as a human, you know they're all related, but how does the software? Well, when each span is sent, we of course generate a span ID per span, which is unique to that span, but we also generate a second ID and use that ID across all of the spans, and that's the trace ID. So now you've got a selection of spans, but also they're all connected with this single trace ID, and that's how the backend knows that all of those spans belong together. So imagine two people pushing their day into the same OpenTelemetry backend. That's how the backend can decide that's Adam's day and that's Jane's day. And that would be absolutely fine if humans did only one thing at once, but we don't. We multitask. We drink coffee and drive to work. We answer emails and, you know, be on Zoom calls and watch YouTube videos at the same time. So how do we handle that in OpenTelemetry? Well, actually, it's quite easy. We tell some of the spans that they are children of other spans. It's not that difficult. We just send a parent span ID with the newly created spans, and magically, the backend knows how to show that relationship. So for example, if you wanted more detail of your breakfast, you could say, here's another span, I'm opening the fridge, or boiling the kettle, or pouring water and adding the tea bag. And all of those spans inside making breakfast would reference the parent span of making breakfast. And so you have this kind of parent-child relationship. So notice something here. Traces can become very large and complicated very, very quickly, depending on the level of granularity that you choose to record with. And that level of granularity determines how complex and big that trace is. Now, the size and the complexity become important for two reasons: usability and storage costs. To summarize, a span is the smallest unit of work that you choose to track, and a trace is nothing more than a logical grouping of those spans. So when we send multiple spans that we want to be correlated, we send the spans with the same trace ID. And finally, spans can be organized into groups and subgroups within the trace to denote the parent and child relationship. So I hope this quick video was informative and helps you understand the differences between spans and traces in OpenTelemetry. Thanks, and I'll see you next time. Bye.